Am I audible to all of you? So today's class, as most of you requested, we are going to take today's class on reading comprehensions. Okay. Now today's class, I'm not only focusing on telling you about what reading comprehension is, solving a few questions and going away, but today's class I want to focus more on improving your general English. Okay. Just 1 minute. Yes. I've already given my WhatsApp number the last few days, but just give me 1 minute. I'll send it in the what all chat again. Okay. Yeah, this is my WhatsApp number, so all of you can have this. But yes, so as I have noticed that most of you, your problem is not only in reading questions and answering them. Your problem is in general with English. Your problem is in talking English. Your problem is with reading and understanding English. Your problem is being confident with English. Your problem is with the language altogether. And I kind of understand why this fear of English has come to you. Look, first of all, let's break a few stereotypes. First of all, let's try to understand English is a foreign language. Okay. Why does it not look like a foreign language? Because we've been seeing the script of English throughout our life. That does not mean we are experts in English. Okay. That does not mean we should have known everything in English. Okay. It's completely fine for you not to understand a lot of things in English because you are not born in an English speaking nation. Okay. Once you have this clarity, once you understand this limitation, only then we can try to bring ourselves to a level wherein we are comfortable with English. Okay. Now, to be very honest, I'll give you one example. And this example is not of someone very great. It's of a very small person. I'm talking about myself here. Okay. So I don't know how many of you know this about me, but my 12th grade, I am from this very city. I studied in Vishakha Valley School my entire life from 5th till 12th grade. And my 12th grade CBSE score in English was 96. Okay. But I don't know how many of you know this about me. I failed English in 8th grade. Okay. And today I sit here. I've been scoring 99 percentile in CAT for the last 3 years in English. So it does not matter where you start. Okay. All of us have struggled with this language once in our life, at least once in our life. Okay. So please just understand that this language will continue to scare you if you don't continue to use it. Or the only way to gain confidence with this language is for you to keep reading, keep understanding, keep posing questions. 90% of us read a particular matter, think about what that matter is, and then go forward. But then there is that 10% of us that blindly read a matter and go forward. We assume we have understood things, but we are not understanding things, we are just reading things. Okay. So from today, what I really want you to do is whenever you're reading any part of a passage, whenever you're reading any part of an article, may that be a storybook, may that be something that you have written on your own, may it be a newspaper, may it be the lyrics of a song, you're questioning yourself, what does this mean? You're asking yourself, why is this written like this? And you're asking yourself, if I don't write it this way, would it still mean the same thing? Okay. Am I audible to all of you? Are you guys able to understand what I'm saying? I think I have somewhere 320 participants so far. Yes. So all of you are comfortable with this speed of mine. You guys are able to understand, right? Yeah, good. Now, let's go to the first slide. And in today's class, again, I'm telling you very, very honestly, very, very clearly, before I start the class itself, I want to address the core problems in you understanding English. This class will not be taking care of a lot of concepts while you are solving your CRT questions. This class will be taking care of a lot of basics in reading comprehension. Okay, just like what we've done with parajumbles, I will first teach you the basics of reading comprehensions, make you learn how to read effectively, tell you what are the good reading habits so that you don't find it difficult when you're reading your reading comprehension. And then I will show you a few passages with questions so that you get to know what kind of questions will come in your exams. Okay? Is that okay? Well, the PPT is already made, so there's not much of a choice in that. So let's go forward. So what are reading comprehensions? Well, reading comprehensions test your understanding of a given textual matter. All right. Now, it's not one skill that they test. They test the student on the basis of A, your interpretation of facts. Okay. So let us say that there's a train that is starting from Visakhapatnam till Hyderabad at 3 o'clock. Okay. And somewhere in the middle near Vijayawada or somewhere, I don't know if that's the route, but if, let's suppose that's the route, okay, somewhere near Vijayawada, I am derailed from the tracks. Now, if I'm sharing this information, can you honestly tell me whose fault it is for that train to get derailed? I'm just giving you this piece of information. There's a train starting from Visakhapatnam to Hyderabad at 3 o'clock today. Near Vijayawada, it got derailed from the tracks. So whose mistake is this? Railways. Okay, why did I tell you that railways did not lay the track somewhere or anything? Driver, did I tell you that the driver was asleep? Okay, loco pilot, did I tell you that the loco pilot was missing or maybe the driver was drinking or anything? Did I tell you anything like that? Maintenance staff, most probably we cannot decide with this info, right? Yeah, it cannot be interpreted. So always, always think about what you are going to say. Okay, fate, Meher, it's not fate for sure. No, we can't blame everything on fate. Now, think about it. Just think about it. Had I told the same information in a different manner, the utter lack of maintenance of the train tracks by the South Central Railways led to a derailment of a train near Vijayawada, which started from Visakhapatnam on its journey to Hyderabad. Now tell me whose mistake is this? Definitely the South Central Railways. Yes, now all of you are able to get it. So always remember, we should always be objective when we are reading a passage. In the first time when I told the same information, also some people were saying about railways, no? But that was not the railway's mistake. In the second time when I made the passage like this, then you understood that it's the railway's mistake very clearly, no? So that is what I mean by interpretation of facts. Okay? A fact will be presented to you, but how do you interpret it becomes a matter of your assumption. So when you are reading a passage, please do not assume anything at all. Okay? The second thing that the RCs will test you about is relationship between arguments. Okay? Now, you guys read your newspaper sometimes, right? For example, in the very recent present, we've had this big issue of the removal of the SEC, the Estate Election Commissioner, by Mr. Jagmohan Reddy, correct? And he drew a lot of criticism for that issue. Now, one could argue, if I was from Y.S. Jagmohan Reddy's party, which is which party? Yes, it's YSRCP. So if I was from the YSRCP party, I would argue that I did not do anything wrong. Some Allahabad High Court gave some kind of a decision before in some other case in 2007. I just used that decision to take this decision. Now, is it wrong for me to say that? Obviously not. But if I'm not putting that argument forward, then the whole mistake falls onto me, no? Just like your South Central Railways. So a student should always be very careful before he relates the arguments. Okay? Sometimes the arguments that are present in the passage are supposed to be read together. And sometimes you have to take each argument individually. So in this class, I will tell you where you have to consider what type of an understanding process. But don't worry, what I want you to understand is, first thing, you have to be very objective when you read your passage. Second thing, you should be very attentive while you read your passage, because you have to be able to relate the arguments. And third thing that they are going to test you on is the application of your implications. That means, when you are interpreting a fact, how are you deriving a conclusion out of that fact? How are you drawing inferences from that fact? Okay? Now, these are three main areas where they test you in a reading comprehension in any of the exams. Okay? And mind you, no matter which exam you're taking, I will give you a huge list of exams today that this is a part of. Okay? Let us start with your normal, very basic exams, CRTs. Then let us go for all your MS entrance exams, like your GRE, okay, and all. Then all your MBA entrance exams, like your CAT, GMAT, okay, maybe also CAT, GMAT, you have SNAP, you have IIFT. Well, you have a list of at least 20 different exams you can write in this country to get into an MBA course. Okay? Yeah. That's what I was saying, no? You have at least 20 different exams that you can write to get into an MBA from this country. Okay? You have that. You have you have something called as NMAT. You have something called as MICAT. You have ISET. Yeah, you have ISET. In fact, Geetham also has GAT or something. I don't know. Okay. So, you have all these exams. And then comes your famous exams, your SSC, UPSC, and then your state SSC. So you have your APPSC and all, right? Then you have the all-time favorite exams, SBIPO, IBPSPO. Yeah, you have RRB, Railway Recruitment Board exams. And then you have defense exams. Correct. Then you have LIC exams. I mean, India is like, you know, it has more exams than it has festivals, but whatever. Yeah, CDS is a central defense training, no? Ishwar. So yeah, India has more exams than festivals, but every exam, no matter what you're doing, has reading comprehensions. Okay. Every single exam has reading comprehensions. Why? Because even after the job you take up, no matter which job you're taking, you will have to read. Yeah, GATE, no, GATE does not have. Yes, there are MBA programs in IIT, but that's not the point. There are MBA programs in IIT, IIT Delhi, IIT Madras, all of these schools offer MBA programs. Okay, but the whole point being, GATE does not have reading comprehensions as far as I know. Anyways. The point is, 99.99% of the exams will ask you for reading comprehensions, because no matter what kind of a job you're doing, you will have to come across a lot of new material. Okay? And all of this material will be something that you are not aware of. So you just have to read that piece of information, understand it immediately, and go ahead with your job. Yes, civil services do have reading comprehensions, Nana. They don't ask you in that length, but they do have a reading comprehension. Okay? All right. Now, before you read a passage, this is what I want you to remember. I want you to start with the passage and not the questions. The reason I'm telling you this is this. So imagine in a passage, okay, there is someone like an author who is writing the passage. And then the questions are made by the examiner. Abhi, that's a really good question. which exam has the highest difficulty of RCs? This is a very tough question to answer because there's no one correct answer. In terms of quality, so far I've found that the CAT passages are the best. Okay. In terms of vocabulary, I found that the GMAT passages are the best. Okay. So if I have to look at it from a perspective of an Indian student, I think GMAT has the most difficult passages whatsoever. SPI PO passages are pretty easy according to me. Again, I'm not talking about you, Ivani Krishna. SBI PO passages are somewhat easier than CAT passages is what I feel. Okay, but GMAT passages are an absolute delight to solve. If you can solve a few GMAT passages, then definitely you guys can solve the CRT passages very easily. Aptitude and Verbalins, CAT, CRT are in the same level. No. Gayatri, please do not make that mistake of thinking that the aptitude in your CAT and CRT are at the same level. They most certainly are not. Okay. The aptitude in CAT is much, much harder than what you see in your CRT. Okay. I will tell you why reading the questions is wrong. And this is strictly what I have been doing. This is strictly what I have been following. And this has yielded me very good results. So that's why I'm telling you this. The passage is written by an author. Author has his own perspective. And the questions are made by an examiner. The examiner has his own perspective. So if you're looking at the examiner's perspective before, that means if you're looking at the questions before, you're not completely understanding the author's perspective. But every question starts with, in the author's opinion, which is correct? Or in the author's opinion, which is wrong, correct? No one is asking about the examiner's opinion. Huh? So if you're looking at the examiner's opinion or the questions before, your mind will go into choosing the wrong interpretation. Like I showed you about the previous thing about the railways. Remember, I only told you that there's been an accident. I never told anyone's mistake in that passage. But when I asked you, whose mistake is it? You immediately told me railways, no? Why? Because your mind was channeling. It was searching for someone's mistake. You were looking to complete an answer. Okay. And that is what is going to happen to you in big passages also. So please never ever look at the questions before you read the passage. And in a very simple manner, if I have to tell you, if you read and understand the passage, every question is just a simple conversation. Okay? Am I clear now? Why I'm telling you to read the passage before? Boys and girls? Okay. Now, the second thing is have undivided attention because let me be very, very clear again. If you're not having your undivided attention, your reading speed is going to be very bad. Okay, and if your reading speed is bad, if you take many breaks while you're reading the passage, your understanding will also go down. There's a Harvard University study that says that people who read fast also read better. Okay, and it's kind of useless if you're reading, you know, slow, but you'll have to read it 2-3 times. That's kind of wasting your time, no? So let's have an undivided attention when you're reading. When you're reading, don't think about anything. If you're thinking about anything else, please stop reading then. Take your time. As I tell you, even in the class, this is what I tell you. If you're not able to pay attention in the class, that's completely fine. You at the best, we are all human. Okay, it is natural for us to deviate our attention sometimes. That is when you should go relax and come back. Maybe take a small walk around your house. Come back, sit, start reading. Okay, don't force yourself to be attentive. Pay attention naturally. Okay. Third, you need to be objective and not have any preconceived notions. As you've seen in that example that I gave you in the starting of this class, if you have a preconceived notion, if you're thinking, yes, government is bad, YS Jagan is bad for everything, you will think everything is what he's doing is bad only. If you think PM Modi is very great, you will think whatever he's doing is very great only. Okay. So even if PM Modi does something very bad, you will not recognize that. Or even if Jagan does something very good, we will not recognize that. So you should be very objective. You should not have your own notions before you start reading a passage. Because always remember, no one cares about your opinion in the passage. we only care about the author's opinion in the passage. Okay, think of it like this. Every reading comprehension is a conversation. The author is speaking to you. And just because the author is already dead or probably not in your vicinity, we can't talk back to him. So we only have to listen to him and understand what he is trying to tell us. Okay? All right. Now, how do we read fast? How do we read with a good speed? Now, before I tell you how to read with a good speed, I want you to be able to understand whatever I'm telling. Okay, so if at any point of time you guys are facing any difficulty in understanding what I'm saying, please, please, please type it off to a message in a message to me. I will be addressing each and every query as you have seen in the past few days. Okay, now the few considerations that I need you to have is this. Studies show that speed of reading of an individual greatly depends on a few factors. First thing is the length of the passage. Now, obviously, think about it. If it's a very long passage, you're feeling very, very bored to read it. Okay? I think natural. We can't help it. But you have to come over it. How do you overcome that fear of reading long passages? You take multiple short passages and read them. Okay? Now, there is something that I implement in Apex. Okay? In every class of mine, this is something that I implement. After you read one paragraph, okay? Let me say this passage has five paragraphs, okay? After you read one paragraph, take a small break and summarize that paragraph, okay? Maybe summarize it in two lines, okay? Now, why is this important? Well, first of all, it will make you lose your boredom. Second, it will make your interpretation better. Okay? So, if you're thinking that the length of the passage is disincentivizing you or it's a deterrent for you to read the passage, it's hard to read very big passages, do this. Follow this trick. Okay? A lot of my students had the same problem. In fact, when I started, even I had the same problem. Even till date, I know a lot of people, they take a book and they complete the book in a day. I can't do that. I'll read a book for like 1-2 hours and then I'll go crazy. I'll leave that book. I'll come back to that book only after one day. So usually I take like 7 days to read a book and all. Okay. Yeah. So most of you might do a book in a day, right? I can't do it. I can't do it at all. Because I get bored very fast. Yeah. No matter how interesting that topic is, I get bored very fast. So this is what I have understood. In the exam, how to keep my boredom out. Because normally, if I'm getting bored, it's okay, Nana. In the exam, if I'm getting bored, then what? That's my job on the line, no? That's my entire career on the line, no? So, read one paragraph, summarize it. Then go to the second paragraph, summarize it. That way, you won't get bored, okay? Second, if the vocabulary involved in a particular passage is very, very complex, a lot of you will feel it's very hard to read the passage, okay? But one thing that we don't realize is that most of these words are nouns, okay? For example, if I were to say, the Royal American Society of Canine Protectors, okay, is working hard. Now, can I say that this part, Royal American Society of Canine Protectors, this whole thing is nothing but a name of a company or a name of an organization? Yeah. So, how does it matter if I say the XYZ is working hard? Yes. So, A, that improves your reading speed. B, that takes off your fear from big words. As long as those words are nouns, you can replace them with whatever you want. Okay, am I clear? Am I able to, are you guys able to understand what I'm saying? Okay, all right. Next, the genre of the passage. Now, 90% of the students attending this class are engineers. Yes. So, you guys are comfortable reading a science article.
because you kind of understand it, right? But instead of giving you a science article, if I give you a very complex article on politics, or if I give you a very complex article on economics, or if I give you an article about stock markets, maybe a few of you will be struggling, no? That is what I mean by the genre of the passage, okay? So this is again a distinct thing. How do you come out of this fear? Every single day, I want you to read only one article. Okay? But if you are reading that article from the page one on Monday, I want you to read an article from page three on Tuesday. On Wednesday, from page five. Okay? Take the newspaper every day, read one article at least and put it down. And never read the articles on the same page. Why? This will give you a overall understanding of different genres. If you carefully observe, no alternate page has the same genre ever. Okay, unless it's a Sunday newspaper and they have a lot of stuff to print, they don't usually give the same genre in any alternative page. Okay, so if you do these things, it'll be very, very beneficial. Now, Avinash, what I mean to say, I will show you an example in the passage and I'll tell you, okay? So maybe this is a little harder for you to understand. When I'm showing you a passage, I'll tell you this example again. All right? Can I move forward? Guys, can I move forward? Okay. See, if you guys don't reply, no, I get this doubt that, okay, maybe you guys put me on mute and you started doing your works. So don't do that. Yeah, thank you. All of you are replying. Thank you so much. Now, how do you improve your reading speed? To improve your reading speed, no, there's again a MIT study which tells you that reading in columns is easier. Have you ever observed that to read newspapers, it's kind of hard to read textbooks. To read newspapers, it's kind of easy than to read textbooks. So in textbook, you have your characters are placed in rows, correct? But if you look at newspapers, they're placed in small columns. Okay, you want me to repeat how effectively to read newspaper articles and learn vocabulary? This is the way we go ahead, Nana. If you're doing page one on Monday, do page three on Tuesday, do page five on Wednesday, okay? And whenever you see a new word, make a flashcard of it. Remember in the first class of mine, the vocabulary class, I asked you to make flashcards. Like that, every time you see a new word, make a flashcard and write down the synonyms of it. So that every morning when you wake up, you have to see that flashcards once. Every night when you sleep, you have to see that flashcards once. Okay, now even without you spending 10 minutes on it, no, you will remember all those words within 2 weeks. That's how your subconscious memory works. It's the same way like you go to your new college. For example, the first day you went to GVP, you might have found it hard to find all your classes, no? Where was the playground? Where was your classes? Where was the teacher's chambers and all that? But after 1 week of repeatedly going to the college, you got used to that, no? Yeah? This is also like that only. Okay? Now, me just telling you that reading in columns is easier is very stupid if I don't show it to you. So what I have done is I've made two passages. I've taken two passages and these passages have been taken from a very, very good source. It's the same source that CAT passages are syndicated out of. So what I want you to do is I want you to read this one passage. Okay? I want you to read this one passage, but before you read, let me tell you the length of this passage is 147 words. Okay? And I want you to start recording the time from the start to the end of the passage, and I want you to note down the time you take. If you're not noting your time, whatever you're reading is completely futile. There's no point in it. Okay? Yeah? In my clock, the time currently is 4:10. Oh, where's my marker? Okay. My clock, the time is 4:10. You guys can take your own time, but the maximum permissible time I'm giving you is still 4:15. Or let's do it 4:13. Okay? So please start, read this passage, and in the comments, please tell me how much time you have taken. Ishwar, if you are done, you need to tell me how much time you took. Guys, if you are done, tell me how much time you've taken. 45 seconds, good. 2 minutes, wow, okay. Notice me, senpai. What's your name, dude? Because you've been noticed. Someone asked me the meaning of the word shipwrecked, I guess. So there's not much of a meaning for shipwrecked. So a ship was there which got wrecked. That means it broke. So that is shipwrecked. So 90% of you are reading it within 1 minute 20 seconds. Yeah, that's what I'm seeing. 1 minute 20 seconds is what most of you are reading it in. Okay. All right. Some of you are done with 45 seconds. Good. So let us read this. Let us read this and let's try to understand what's happening in this passage. Okay. All right. Okay. So some of you are taking 2 minutes. Okay. No problem. No problem. Let us read this passage and let us try to understand what is happening in this particular passage. In 1859, around 450 passengers on the Royal Charter returning from the Australian gold mines to Liverpool drowned when the Stream Clipper was shipwrecked off the north coast of Wales. What makes this tragic loss of life remarkable among countless other maritime disasters was that many of those on board were weighed down by the gold in their money belts that they just wouldn't abandon so close to home. Humans have a particularly strong and at times irrational obsession with possessions. Every year, car owners are killed or seriously injured in their attempts to stop theft of their vehicles. A choice that few would make in the cold light of day. It's as if there is a demon in our minds that compels us to fret over the stuff we make, the stuff we own, and make risky lifestyle choices in the pursuit of material wealth. I think we are possessed. Now, it took me 52 seconds to read this out. Okay. Now, it's a very common understanding that your reading speed, while speaking speed, is different. Meaning of fret. Fret is worry. Fretting is worrying, Nana. W-O-R-R-Y. Worry. I think Meher also asked me about fret, right? So fret is worry. Okay? Yeah. So what is he talking in this chapter, in this particular passage? He's saying that, you know, he gave an example wherein almost 450 passengers who were returning from Australia to Liverpool. Where is Liverpool? Liverpool is in the United Kingdom. Okay. Obsession ante pitchi nana. Obsession ante pitchi. Sarena? Okay. Yeah. Liverpool is in England, the UK. Alright. So now it's very, very simple. If we are looking at abandon is leaving off. Abandoning is leaving. Vodileno. Okay. What is he telling? He's saying that there was an accident in a ship. Now, these idiot fellows who were on the ship, instead of swimming off properly, they started taking their gold and all in their pockets. Because that gold was very heavy, they also went down into the sea. There are some people who get very seriously injured or killed trying to stop the people from stealing their cars. Now, the question he's asking is, why are we worrying about the stuff we are owning and making risky lifestyle choices? ఆ వస్తువు పోతే పోయాయి, మనం ఏమో మన లైఫ్ ని ఎందుకు పాడు చేసుకోవడం అని వాడు అడుగుతున్నాడు ప్యాసేజ్ లో. అంతే కదా, నౌ దట్స్ వాట్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్ మీన్స్. నో ఎస్ ఆర్ నో? నౌ హౌ మెనీ ఆఫ్ యూ అండర్స్టాండ్ ది ప్యాసేజ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఐ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్డ్ ఇట్? ఓకే, నౌ యు గైస్ రిమెంబర్ ద టైమ్ దట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టేకెన్ టు రీడ్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్, రైట్? ఎస్. Okay, now read this passage, the read the next passage. Sai Durga Bharadwaj, okay, I'll explain this once again. See, he's over here. Yeah, I'm explaining once again. Look at this passage. See, from this part till here, okay, he is giving an example of one ship that started in Australia, which was going to Liverpool. Some accident happened with some part of that ship. I don't know what a steam clipper is. I never worked in a ship. But yeah, I'm guessing it's an important part. Otherwise, the ship wouldn't have crashed, right? So yeah. So there was a tragic loss of life. That means a lot of people died. Enduku? Endukante, even when they were getting off, they were weighed down by the gold. Yes, they were weighed down by the gold. అంటే వాళ్ళు ఇంటి దగ్గరికి వచ్చాం కదా, ఇంకెందుకు డబ్బులు వదిలేసుకోవడం, ఆ మాత్రం మనం ఏమో స్విమ్ చేసేయలేమా అనుకుని తీసుకుని వెళ్ళిపోయారట. అలా అవక వాళ్ళు ఏమో వచ్చి చనిపోయారు అని రాశాడు. ఎస్, ఆర్ ఆల్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ దట్ పార్ట్? గుడ్. నౌ హ్యూమన్స్ హ్యావ్ అ వాట్? హ్యూమన్స్ హ్యావ్ అ పర్టికులర్లీ స్ట్రాంగ్ అండ్ అట్ టైమ్స్ ఇర్రేషనల్ అబ్సెషన్. దట్ మీన్స్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఫర్ దట్ అబ్సెషన్. మనం ప్రాణాలు వదులుకుంటావా కార్ వదులుకుంటావా అంటే, ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ ఆస్కింగ్ యూ విల్ యూ లీవ్ యువర్ లైఫ్ ఫర్ అ కార్, యూ విల్ సే అ కార్ ఓన్లీ, నో? బట్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ విల్ ఫైట్ విత్ ద పీపుల్ ఆర్ ట్రైయింగ్ టు స్టీల్ అవర్ కార్, ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ దే టెల్ అస్ దట్ దే కిల్ అస్. సో దట్ ఈస్ అన్ ఇర్రేషనల్ అబ్సెషన్. నౌ ద ఆథర్ ఈస్ సేయింగ్ దట్ హీ డస్ నాట్ అండర్స్టాండ్ వై సమ్ టైమ్స్ పీపుల్ హ్యావ్ సచ్ ఇర్రేషనల్ అబ్సెషన్ అబౌట్ దేర్ పొజెషన్స్. Cold day of light is in any condition of light, Nana. That means in the harshest realities of light. In the harshest realities of light. Okay? So the author is questioning why. I think there is some demon in our heads. That is why we are making such risky lifestyle choices. Okay? That means we are not thinking correctly. Okay? Now is it clear, all of you? Divyashree, once check your mic settings, Nana, because everyone is able to hear. Okay, all right. So now read this passage. Okay, see, this passage is 159 words. The last passage was 147 words. This is 159 words, but I have placed this in columns. Okay. So start reading this passage according to me. Right now the time is 4:20. Please tell me what is the time that you take in minutes. Okay, start. Okay, 1 minute, 56 seconds, 23 seconds, 45 seconds, 31 seconds. The word under apex symbol is usually, I guess. So now, if you look at this timing that you have, 99% of you in my all chat have come down to 1 minute 15 seconds or 1 minute 30 seconds at max. Okay, there's no one who is writing 2 minutes anymore. There's no one who's written 2 minutes now. Okay. Now, what does that mean? That means we are able to read columns faster than rows, correct? So how can we read fast? Anytime they give you any kind of a text matter, try to look at it from farther. Okay? Nana Abhi, that word is going to be usually. Okay? Just give me 1 minute. I'll check what that word is. I'll get back to you. Don't worry at all. Okay. Apex logo is become bigger. Parled branding undalkal maa matram. That is used 10 nana. Okay. The word before logo is used 10. Okay. The word that was hidden by the logo is used 10. Serena. Okay, fine. Now, how much time did it take for you people? Good. So it's taking less time, no? Now, this is a science and technology passage, so it's kind of easier for you also. Should we read it and understand what this is? In the mid-1980s, evidence started to emerge from labs across the world, confirming that scientists were finally able to reach the nano level in experimental conditions and were not just working just with their theories. Working at scales defined in millions of a millimeter, Richard Smalley, Robert Crowell, and Harold Proto reported the discovery of Buckminster fullerene. Now, remember I told you that whenever we are getting nouns, yes, we don't need to think about it. See. You guys are all science students. I'm a science student, so we know what is C60 Buckminster fullerene. Now, if I give this passage to a common student, what will happen? What age has that girl starting? Now, what should we do? Whenever I'm getting these names, Richard Smalley, Robert Curl, Harold Croto, whatever this is, I will take this Richard Smalley is A, this guy is B, this guy is C. Okay? What is Buckminster fullerene? I will call it a ball. Because Buckminster fullerene looks like a ball only, no? It looks like a football, no? Yes, that's what he's given over here, no? So I will call this a ball. So next time, whenever I'm seeing Buckminster fullerene, no? I will say ball only. Okay. So now what is happening? Your reading speed is increasing, but you're understanding what is there in that passage. Correct. So that is what I want you guys to do. Whenever you're getting nouns, whenever you're getting the names, then you should always consider replacing those names if they are very, very complex. Okay? Yes, that's what I'm saying, Nana. Soumya, if there are a lot of names in a passage, then it's very easy for you to skip those names and read it fast. Now, this is a direct passage. There's nothing to explain in this passage. It's just a newspaper article that I've copied. Okay? Now, one more thing about your speed reading before I go to the different question types. Observe this, guys. All of you observe this. When you are reading, no, your tongue is moving. Always when you're reading, even when you're reading it in your mind, no, you're moving your tongue. Think about this. If you're moving your tongue, your speed of reading is not your speed of reading, it's your speed of speaking. You people can read very fast, but you cannot speak that fast. So consciously try not to move your tongue. ఇంత చిన్న చిన్న విషయాల వల్ల టైం సేవ్ అవుతుందా అంటే డెఫినెట్ గా అవుతుంది. ఓకేనా? వెన్ యూఆర్ రీడింగ్ అ పర్టికులర్ ప్యాసేజ్ ఆర్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ నౌ ఆన్, ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ మూమెంట్ ఆన్, ప్లీజ్ కాన్షియస్లీ అవాయిడ్ మూవింగ్ యువర్ టంగ్. ఫస్ట్ 5 to 10 to 20 ప్యాసేజెస్ విల్ బి వెరీ హార్డ్ ఫర్ యూ. అసలు మీకు తెలియదు కూడా మీ టంగ్ మూవ్ అవుతోంది అన్నట్టు, ఎందుకంటే మీకు అలవాటు అయిపోయింది కనుక. But for the first 10-15 passages, we consciously stop that tongue from moving, your reading speed will increase by at least 1.5 times. Okay? Now, what are the different question types? The first question type is direct or factual. Second one is implied idea or assumption based. And the third one is vocabulary based. Okay? నేను ఇలా డైరెక్ట్గా చెప్పేస్తే మీకు ఏం అర్థం కాదని నాకు తెలుసు. సో ఐ గాట్ సమ్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ ఫర్ యూ. ఓకే, బిఫోర్ ఐ గో టు దట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, ఐ వాంట్ యూ టు రీడ్ దిస్ పర్టిక్యులర్ ప్యాసేజ్ అగైన్. ఐ విల్ టెల్ యూ వాట్ ఈస్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్. ఓకే, ఐ విల్ టెల్ యూ వాట్ ఇస్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ ప్యాసేజ్. ద లెంత్ ఇస్ 212 వర్డ్స్. ఇస్ దట్ క్లియర్? సో ఐ వాంట్ యూ to tell me how much time you are taking to read this passage. In my clock, the time is 4:25. So you guys can go ahead and start reading this passage. Very good. So most of you have completed this. Wow. In less than 45 seconds to 1 minute. Wow. That's good, no? Were you able to read this fast even before? Some of you are saying yes. Some of you are saying no. So those of you who are saying no, it's very good that you're trying to improve. You're improving. And those of you are saying yes, very good, Nana. You've always been good in that case. It's nothing that I've done. So it's all your hard work. The rest of you keep following these small tricks that I'm giving you. So if you start reading fast now, you'll get interest in reading also. ఇప్పుడు చూడండి, మీరు ఏదైనా బుక్ పట్టుకుని అదే బుక్ ఏమో మీరు ఒక వారం రెండు వారాలు చదివారు అనుకోండి, మీకు కూడా దాని మీద బోర్ కొడుతుంది. అదే ఒక బుక్ మీద పట్టుకుని రెండు మూడు రోజుల్లో కంప్లీట్ చేస్తారనుకోండి, మీకు కూడా ఇంట్రెస్టింగ్ గా ఉంటుంది కదా. Impediment is some kind of a stoppage, Nana. Impediment is some kind of a trouble, a stoppage, obstacle. Yeah, it can be obstacle. Okay, so I will start explaining this passage now. I think it's good enough time for me to explain this passage. Yes. So as the economic role of multinational global corporations expand, that means the role of these things are increasing. The international economic environment will be shaped increasingly not by governments or international institutions, but by the interactions between governments and global corporations, especially in the United States, Europe and Japan. Why did he say United States, Europe and Japan? Because these are really big what economies. These are really stable and big economies. Somehow I'm not able to convince myself with that statement in this recent COVID time, because India is helping almost every country outside. But yeah, whatever. A significant factor in this shifting world economy is the trend toward regional trading blocks of nations, which has a potentially large effect on the evolution of the world trading system. Two examples of this trend are the US, United States, Canada Free Trade Agreement. Okay, so what is this? This is US, Canada Free Trade Agreement. Any next time I'm seeing that, I will only think of this. And Europe, okay, the move by the European community to dismantle. What is dismantle, guys? What is the meaning of the word dismantle? Dismantle is remove. Okay. And what is impediments? Obstacles or difficulties. Okay. So, yeah. The move by the European community to remove the difficulties to the free flow of goods, services, capital and labor among member states by the end of 1992. Okay, that means these were the two examples of this trend which these particular European community tried to do for what? For removing the difficulties in flow of goods and other things. However, now see, whenever I'm getting however, what did we learn in parajumbles? We learned that the next part will be an opposite, no? So this part was a good thing. So now we are going to see some bad thing, okay? However, although numerous political and economic factors were operative in launching the move to integrate the EC markets, concerns about a protectionism within the EC does not appear to have been a major consideration. Hey, what is this EC again, Nana? What is this EC? This EC is nothing but the European community. Okay, just like this FTA is nothing but the free trade agreement. Okay, all that is fine. What is protectionism? Protectionism ante enta telsa? How many of you know the meaning of protectionism? How many of you read any economics articles anytime after your 10th standard? How many of you have touched economics? So not a lot of you have touched economics. So I'll ask you a small question. Do you know this car, Range Rover? Yeah, so all of you know the car Range Rover. Abba, car lante andar ki telsu. And you know this car about Tata cars, no? Which is costlier, Range Rover or Tata? Obviously Range Rover. Even if I'm taking the highest end model of Tata, even then Range Rover is only costlier. Why? The same cost won't be there for Range Rover in the country that is making Range Rover. Alage ippudu nenu US kelli Tata car konukovali ankonde, it'll be very costly. So basically what I am telling, it's not only customs, Nana, basically what I am telling is that because US or because India is making Tata cars, India will want people of India to use Tata cars. Why? Because then the money will be flowing inside the country only. Instead of that, if I'm allowing a lot of foreign players to come, most of my country's money is going outside, no? Yes? So that part is called as protectionism. Yes, protecting domestic companies from foreign companies by charging taxes. That is protectionism. Kanna, the meaning of the word overwhelming is too much emotion. Okay? The overwhelming reason for that, that means the very emotional reason for that, is a bilateral initiative was fear of increasing United States protectionism. That means, for example, if the EC does not do protectionism in their own thing, whatever are the goods in United States, if I'm sending to United States, they're charging too much taxes. Why? So that their own companies will develop. Okay, now that is wrong, no? So that is why even EC did protectionism. Okay? Soumya Patnana, you didn't understand the meaning of protectionism? How do I explain it with better examples? Okay, let us say that you are making a chocolate, Nana, and you want to sell that chocolate for 10 rupees. Now, because you're making the chocolate in India, you're buying all the ingredients from India only, no? Correct? So, if you are buying all the ingredients in India, you are spending enough money on Indian products, no? But instead, if I tell you that I'm going to import chocolates from, Switzerland. If I'm importing chocolates from Switzerland, they made chocolates from the raw materials in Switzerland. So my raw materials in India are staying like that only, no? I am not getting any money for the raw materials in India, no? Correct? That means I'm getting very less part of my money for my own country's products, no kana. So to protect my own businesses, to protect my own country's businesses, I will charge you a tax on Switzerland chocolates. Okay. All right. Sai Ishwar, we are not getting into an economics class here. No, I'm not getting into this discussion because see, for understanding this passage, we don't need to know so much. Anyways, nonetheless, although markedly different in origin and nature, both regional developments are highly significant in that they will foster integration in the two largest and richest markets of the world, as well as provoke questions about the future direction of world trading system. That means both of these, European Community and the FTA, both of these developments are very, very significant. Why? Because they will bring an integration of the two largest and richest markets, the European market and the American-Canadian market. They will bring them together. So if they'll bring them together, then maybe the direction of how world trading system will go on will also change. Okay? That's what this passage is telling us. Now, I told you there are three types of questions, no? Direct or factual, implied idea, and vocabulary-based. We will first look at a direct question. The direct question from this passage will be like this. The passage suggests which of the following about global corporations? And these are your operation. These are your options. Now, come on, take 1 minute. Think about this and answer it. Tarun, Sachin, Shivram, no, you guys are wrong. Pratyusha, you're wrong as well. Sirisha, wrong. Varsha, wrong. Shivakumar, wrong. I don't know why. I'm kind of not enjoying saying wrong, wrong. So I'm not going to tell you that. I'll just tell you the right answer at the end. Someone has given me the right answer. Hey. Who is that who gave me the right answer? 1 minute. Vivek Patnaik. Kudos, mate. You give me the right answer. So far, only Vivek has given me the right answer. Anyways, the correct answer for this question is your one. Okay, the correct answer for this question is option one. Okay, now the reason why option one is correct, Ishwar, yeah, you also gave me the right answer, Nana. Abhi, Surya, a lot of people after this have given me the right answer. So good. The reason why this is a correct answer is because of the first particular line of the statement. Look at this part. As the economic role of multinational global corporation expands, the international economic environment will be shaped increasingly not by governments or international institutions, but by interaction. Okay? Now look, what does that mean? What is that interaction? That interaction is nothing but getting a fully integrated international market. So their continued growth is dependent on the existence of such a market. Okay, so this is a direct question wherein you are able to directly take the answer from the passage. Now the second type of question, what did I tell you will be there? Implied idea or assumption based questions, no? So I will show you one implied idea or assumption based question. Which of the following can be inferred? Can you see this particular word? Can you? So which of the following can be inferred from the passage about the European Community prior to the adoption of the 1992 program? Now, to answer this question, we'll have to first think, why is he telling, what can I understand about the European Community before 1992? What can I understand? Which option do you think is correct? 1, 3, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 4, 2. Wow. So none of you are stuck between 5, no? 5 is definitely wrong, kya? Huh? No one is telling me 5, or Subramanyam, you told me 5, kya? Okay. Sirisha, Surya. No, no, I didn't tell you 5 is the correct answer. I'm just asking, is 5 correct? Now look, to answer this, let's go back to the passage and see what happened in the European community before 1992. Okay? Look, over here, what is there? US Free Trade Agreement of and Europe 1992, the move made by European community to dismantle impediments. That means before 1992, there were some difficulties, no, in the sharing of goods and services and capital among member states. Correct? Now, which option is telling us that? Option 3 or option 4? Which is saying that? Option 3 is telling us that. Correct? So, our right answer will be option 3. Is that clear? Now, are you able to understand how we are attempting our passages? Yeah? Now, if I had looked at this question before and I went back to the answer, no? Went back to the passage, I would have definitely given you a wrong answer. Because we understood the passage before and we came to this question, we are able to think properly. Yeah, we have to think what happened before 1992. Then we went, we saw what happened before 1992 and we came here. Understood? Okay, now, for a vocabulary-based question, from this particular passage, I did not think there's any, you know, good word, a very tough word to ask. But I will give you another vocab-based question. Please read this small passage. Oh, we've already exceeded our time limit. The time is 4:45 almost. So, please try to read this passage quickly. Sai Ishwar, you can text me on WhatsApp, and I'll be more than happy to explain to you on WhatsApp. The thing is, we've already exceeded our time. So I would want you to look at this last passage, and then in the next class, I'll take forward the rest of the RCs. Okay? My number I've put in all chat in the starting, Nana, but at the end of the class, I'll put it in all chat again. Don't worry. Okay? Yeah. So have you read this particular passage? Okay, all right. So the relationship of the vampire and his assistant seemed to have been reversed, and Igor, now in his early 20s, was the authoritative one. Since boyhood, he had been taking on one responsibility after another, until he had left the vampire with nothing to perplex him but how to while away the hours when the servants were busy and Igor was out searching for brains. Meher, I'm so glad you're asking me the meaning of perplex, because that's exactly my question. In this sentence, perplex most nearly means what? Yes, perplex means confused, nothing to confuse him. Okay? So, definitely not one, Nana. It's not about trouble. Okay, I'll eliminate the wrong answers first. It's not trouble. It's not embarrass. It's not entangle. Now, you should be only worried about these two answers. Astonish is surprise. Bewilder is confuse. Okay? Perplex is confuse. So your answer will be 2. Okay? No, the answer is 2. It's not 3. Bad boys. Yeah, Lakshminarayan, I understand you're confused, but you're perplexed probably. But the meaning of perplex is confuse. Okay? So yeah, so such questions are vocab-based questions, Nana. All right. Now, I'm not uploading the PDF of this class today. I'll be uploading the PDF of this class tomorrow when we solve a few more, passages. Okay, I have a few more passages to show you and a few questions. Okay, so once we are done with that part of the lecture, I will upload this entire PDF together. Okay, so for today, this is all that I'm going to share with you. Now, tomorrow's class, we are going to continue on RCs. I hope that's okay with all of you. Yes, you have to get the meaning of the word based on the meaning of the sentence, Nana. In a vocab-based question, you will always have to get the meaning of the word only on the basis of the meaning of the sentence. Because unfortunately, English is a language with many fathers. Okay, it's been taken from a lot of different languages. So every word in English means different things in different contexts. Okay, so all of these vocab-based questions are going to be about contextual vocabulary only. All right. So in tomorrow's class, I'll take you through a journey of at least 2 to 3 good reading comprehension passages. Each reading comprehension passage with 3 or 4 questions so that you get an idea of what you're doing. But for today, what I need you to do is go back home. Obviously, you're home. So, yeah, there's no going back home. So, sit at home and take out your newspaper or any random novel that you have in your home. Read 5 pages of your novel or read 2 articles of your newspaper and summarize them. I want you to be very, very clear of the interpretations that you're making. Okay? Are we clear about that? All right, guys. That's all for now. Thank you so much. Yeah, Sydney Sheldon would be good. Sydney Sheldon would be good. Okay, so yeah. Abhi, as you asked, I am allowing... Thank you, Gayatri. That's a really good compliment. So, Abhi, as you asked, I'm allowing you to annotate now. Oh, don't tell my name. You should have texted that before. Anyway, chalo then, I'll stop sharing the screen. Bye-bye. Take care. Stay safe. Have fun. A lot of people are playing Ludo. So, yeah, maybe you guys also go play Ludo. Bye.